Greetings, and welcome to Fire Engineering's Training Minutes. I'm John Alston, Fire Chief of the City of New Haven. We're going to be talking about extrications that may be difficult. Many times, firefighters not only place themselves at risk in performing their tasks, but the environment itself may be dangerous. There may be Jersey barriers in limited access to our victims. The roof may be compromised. There may be so much traffic that we can only work from one side of the vehicle. The technique that we're going to demonstrate this morning is with a full crew, vehicle stabilized, multiple victims inside, a full car, we want to do a two-door takedown. So as we stated before, we're going to be doing a two-door drop down. Making the scene safe is the most important thing. So we'll tape the windows before we remove the glass. We'll ensure that our victim has been assessed, that even if we have to do a quick door pop just to get a firefighter or medic inside to assess our victim, to cover them up, to make sure that there's no debris, glass, or any sharp metal edges that may affect them during this extrication. Keeping a roll of duct tape inside one of your compartments works wonders. We'll continue to remove the other glass and ensure that it's a safe environment for our firefighters. Remove the other glass. Taking the time to ensure that safety is our primary concern and that our victim is stable and our vehicle is stabilized, those extra 2 to 3 minutes are the most important thing if you're going to be in a prolonged extrication process. Sometimes an extrication could be 3 to 5 minutes. I've seen them go as long as hours. And using a tool and not our hands, we're able to clear the glass out. We're going to start with a battery-operated tool first because it's quicker. A firefighter can step off the rig and go right to work. As you can see with that vertical technique, it immediately moves the door away from the victim and exposes that top hinge for us. Giving us time to reposition the tool, going vertical again, popping the top hinge. At this point, we'd want to get our O cutter in and begin to work on the B post. Also, another member could ensure that everything is detached from this top portion of the door. There are times that you may have to come back and make sure that there's nothing encumbering us from getting the rest of the door down. If our tool begins to roll in the wrong direction that we want, we can stop and turn the tool upside down. What that does is now the tool will roll in the direction that's safer for the firefighter. Removing all the plastic, veneer, and accessories aftermarket are critical that we can get to the bare metal. And we let the tool do the work. One important thing is to continue with the tool. Allow it to keep going. T It's all right. Once it bites the metal, it will continue. Keep going. Trust that the tool will do its job. Keep going. Now open. We now have a clean cut on the B post. With our vertical pop of the top hinge, the O cut onto the B post, this door is starting to come down. The next steps that we need to do are to make sure that we now are able to open the back of this door, weaken the post, and let the weight of the door and our assistance bring both doors down. That way we can extricate all of our victims from this side without being on a hazardous side or a limited access side. With all the advanced equipment that we have, and we're happy to have our brand new rescue rig here with battery operated tools, hydraulic tools, but sometimes the simplest extrication is to try before you pry. Just by unlocking a door exposes all the components in the cage that we need to access to extricate our victims. We'll continue now with the two-door takedown by getting an O-cutter in to weaken the B-post. We get the tool in as deep as we can, and we start. If the tool starts to roll in the wrong direction towards our victim, we can always stop, flip the tool upside down, begin again, and because of the curvature and the scissor action of the blades, it will bring the tool back out to us, safer for the firefighter. Also, if at any time the doors are compromised to a point where they're already weakened, we would use the O-cutter to completely remove them to expose the interior compartment of the car. We always want to leave some of the metal intact so that the door doesn't drop down on us. But if either by accident or intent, we get the entire post removed, it's nothing for us to drag both doors to the forefront portion of the car. As the door becomes vertical and it's weakened, we now clamp onto it. Two firefighters can now each grab the tool and rock the door down. What the tool does is give them increased leverage, and after clearing the sharp metal with the O-cutters, you actually have a workbench to set your stretchers down on. Firefighters do not have to work from an unsafe side. They don't have to work from a side that has limited access. This has been a demonstration of a two-door takedown. As you can tell, during the process, many times the metal will tear in an unpredictable manner. The most important thing is to remain calm, keep the firefighters safe, keep your victims protected, and ensure that you watch out for traffic safety. This is John Alston with the New Haven Fire Department for Fire Engineering's Training Minutes.